أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and the most merciful. This is the virtual learning system of Pakistan International School Thai, session 2020. Welcome and assalamu alaikum to all the students of Class 4, how are you all? We are going to study Islamic studies. I hope you all are ready for the next lesson. We are doing Unit 10, Historical and Cultural Heritage. And in this unit, we will study about the history of Islam. And today our topic is lesson one, Allah's protection of the Kaaba. How did Allah protect his house, which is named by Kaaba? This is our video number 25, and I am your teacher, Imrana Urshid. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Children, please open page number 111 for the reading and explanation of this chapter. This is your book. You have to open page 111. Ready, children? Let's start the reading. As you all know, the name of the chapter is Protection of the Kaaba. It means there is an incident in the past that the protection of Kaaba was in danger, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect his house. Let's see what is the incident mentioned in this chapter. Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi ashabil fil. This is Surah Al-Fil in the last para of the Quran. Have you not considered, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how your Lord dealt with the owner of the elephant? How did Allah protect his house? Let's see what is the real story, which is also mentioned in the Quran and which is very important in the history of Islam, which is related to the birth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. An important event took place in Arabia just before the birth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It means it was a very important event in the history of Arabia. And that event is also related with the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abraha was a Christian governor of Yemen. He was very jealous of the Kaaba because of its high position among the Arabs. Why he was jealous? Because he was Christian and all the people around the Arabia come for the Hajj and for the Ziyarah of the Holy Mecca, and all the trade and all the business was related to that visit of Kaaba. So he was so much jealous with the position of Kaaba among Arabs. He wanted to destroy the Kaaba. He went out with a large accompanied by elephants. Why he wanted to destroy the Kaaba, children? Because he had a very big Kalisa for the Christians to the people of Yemen and Christians around the Yemen area. They went to visit the Kalisa made by Abraham. He wanted to destroy the Kaaba when his plan was, when the Kaaba will be destroyed, all the Arabs will surely visit his Kalisa, his church, and all the trade will turn to the Yemen, not to the Arabs. So he went out with a big, large army accompanied by the elephants, and his plan was to destroy the Kaaba. Open page 112. When he approached Makkah, approached means reached near Makkah, Abraha took Abdul Muttalib's camel. Who was Abdul Muttalib? You all know that Abdul Muttalib was the grandfather of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at that time, when Abraha attacked the Saudi Arabia, Abdul Muttalib was the caretaker of Kaaba. He was the sardar of Makkah, which he found grazing. Abraha took the camels of Abdul Muttalib, found grazing. Abdul Muttalib got angry, and then he met Abraha and requested him to return his camels. When Abdul Muttalib get to know that his elephants were kidnapped by, snatched by Abdul Muttalib, Abraha, he became angry and he went to talk about this with Abraha. Abdul Muttalib met Abraha and asked him, requested him to return his camels. Abraha was surprised and said, "I came to destroy your Kaaba, and you are only concerned about your camels." This was very strange for Abraha, that the leader of Kaaba, the king of the Arabia, is concerned about his camels, and he is not worried about his place, about the Mecca, about the Kaaba, that the army is going to attack Makkah. So he asked him. Abdul Muttalib replied, "The camel belongs to me, but the owner of Kaaba is Allah." He said, "I am concerned only about my things that are camels, and the owner of Kaaba is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will protect it. Who will protect his house? I will protect my camels because they belong to me. And Allah will protect his house because he belongs to Kaaba, it belongs to Allah." Abraha was surprised by this answer and assured that Abdul Muttalib was not going to oppose his plan. And then he said, "I am going to attack the Mecca." Abraha returned Abdul Muttalib's camel and asked him to vacate Makkah. Then he said, "Take all your camels," and vacate means spare Makkah so that he can approach and attack and destroy the Kaaba. Abdul Muttalib left. Abraha went back to his people and ordered them to leave Makkah and take refuge in the mountains. Abdul Muttalib asked all the people that the big army is going to attack Makkah, and their intention is to destroy the holy Kaaba. So Allah will protect his house. We have to protect ourselves and our family and our children. So he asked the people who were living in Makkah around Kaaba to leave it alone and go and make them safe in the mountains. Abraha then advanced, means moved, to destroy the Kaaba. But Allah sent birds carrying small stones. This is the way how Allah protects the big, big army, the huge elephants, with the small birds and small pebbles in their mouth, in their beaks. The birds dropped the stones on Abraha and his soldiers. Many soldiers of Abraha were killed, and Abraha died on his way back to Yemen. Subhanallah, Allah protected his house, and till Yawm al-Qiyamah, the protection of Kaaba is in the hands of Allah. Nobody can approach towards Kaaba. That is how Allah protected his house. It was in the year known as the year of Elephant. It was the year that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born. So this year is also called the year of elephants. This incident is mentioned in Surah Al-Fil. Do you know Surah Al-Fil? A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi ashabil fil. Alam yaj'al kaydahum fi tadlil. وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. The story is mentioned in this surah. Hope you understand and enjoyed all this story. And very interesting information, and you all should keep it in your mind that everything which is protected by Allah, nobody can destroy it. We have done the reading. Now, page number 113, let's start the exercise. This is your page 113. And this is your question and answer, and choose the best answer. Dear children, take out your notebooks and try to write along with me on the question and answer. And if you cannot write now, note down in the homework. Open the screen in front of you of your computer or laptop or mobile, and then note down all the question and answer. Let's start with question number one. Why did Abraha want to destroy the Kaaba? At the start of the lesson, we have read this. Why did Abraha want to destroy the Kaaba? The answer is, Abraha wanted to destroy the Kaaba. Abraha wanted to destroy the Kaaba because he was very jealous of its high position among the Arabs. The spelling of wanted, the N is missing here. Please, you make it correct. Abraha wanted, W-A-N-T-E-D. Abraha wanted to destroy the Kaaba because he was very jealous of its high position among the Arabs. I repeat, why did Abraha wanted to destroy the Kaaba? Abraha wanted to destroy the Kaaba because he was very jealous of its high position among the Arabs. Let's do question number 2. What did Abraha and Abdul Muttalib say to each other? When Abdul Muttalib went to talk about his camels to Abraha, what they converse, what they talk about, and what they say to each other? Answer, Abraha said, I came to destroy your Kaaba. I came to destroy your Kaaba, and you are only concerned about your camels. Abdul Muttalib replied, the camels belong to me, but the owner of the Kaaba is Allah, who will protect it. Abraha said, I came to destroy your Kaaba, and you are only concerned about your camels. Abdul Muttalib replied, camels belong to me, but the owner of the Kaaba is Allah, who will protect it. Who will protect it? Let's do question number 3. How did Allah punish Abraha? How did Allah punish Abraha? The answer, Allah sent birds, Tayran Ababi. Allah sent birds carrying small stones. The birds dropped the stones on Abraha and his soldiers. Many soldiers were killed and Abraha died on his way back to Yemen. Allah sent birds carrying small stones. The birds dropped the stones on Abraha and his soldiers. Many soldiers were killed and Abraha died on his way back to Yemen. What is the significance of the event? What is the significance of the event? What is the significance of the event? The event shows, significance means result, outcome, influence. The event shows that how Allah destroyed those who disobeyed him and how he protected the believers. This event shows that how Allah destroyed those who disobeyed him and how he protected the believers. SubhanAllah. Question number 5. This is our last question of this lesson. What occurred later in the year of the elephant? You all know the answer. It was the year that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. In the year of elephant, who was born? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. Hope you all note it down. If not, if you are in delay, you can write it in the homework. Write the unit number, lesson number, and question answer on the notebook. Also, this is our MCQs exercise number 2 of page number 113. Abraha was the governor of, in our three options, Yemen, Habsha, Hijaz. What is the answer? Yemen. Abraha was the governor of Yemen. Number two, Abdul Muttalib was custodian of the, I give you three options, Quraysh, Kaaba and Makkah. So the answer is Makkah. The third one, Abraha had his army were Abraha and his army were destroyed by, I give you three options, elephants, camels or birds. The answer is birds. The last one, no, next one, number four, the year Abraha was defeated is known as the year of, I give you three options, sorrow, the elephant or migration. The year of the elephant. The last one is Abraha was jealous of Quraysh, Makkah or Kaaba, jealous of the position of the Kaaba. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We have done the exercise. Thanks for watching the video. Learn and write question and answer on your notebook. This is your homework. Subhanakallahumma nashhadu an la ilaha illa nastaghfiruka wa natubu alayk. May Allah protect you from this coronavirus and your school will start at the normally and we will study together in the school inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.